Welcome back, students. So session 5 continues, but this is video 10, and even the concept continues. Whatever we saw during the last session, a similar concept continues, but it is little bit advanced question. Let's see the question. We had seen 3, if you remember, and all 3 were monotonous. Similar type. Now this is slightly different. Show that 3 root 2 is irrational. Children, you have to be very careful here now. You might say root 2 is irrational. So 3 root 2 is also irrational. That is true, but you will have to show which prime number whose square root is existing here? Root 2. So if you want to prove 3 root 2 is irrational, first you will have to prove root 2 is irrational. Whatever may be given in your textbook, please be careful. Present your answer how I am teaching you here. Please. Okay? It is because of that theorem, theorem 1.4. What it says, root 2 is irrational. You may take that. Yeah, because root 2 is there. Okay, you may write directly, but I don't want that. If it was, if p is prime and root p is irrational, then you could have used shortcuts. But here you can't. You will realize as we do what I'm trying to say. Solution. First, we show that root 2 is irrational. Sir, root 2 is irrational. And the whole story we have to write here. I'm not going to write. I'm sure by after looking at those 3 sums, you will be able to do it. I'll start and end. Suppose root 2 is rational. We suppose the reverse. Instead of irrational, we suppose rational. I.e. root 2 is equal to A upon B, where B is not equal to 0, and HCF of A and B is equal to 1. We call it result number 1. Then whatever you have to write, you write. Thus, root 2 is irrational. Call it result first. This is 1, 2, 3. And this is Roman figure. First. Alright. Root 2 is irrational. We proved. Now, we move to this statement. What we have to prove? 3 root 2 is irrational. Again, the same thing. Suppose 3 root 2 is rational, i.e. 3 root 2 is of the form P upon Q, where Q not equal to 0. Here we don't need this condition to write here, where HCF of P and Q is equal to 1. We don't need that, so I'm not writing. Okay? Well, keeping root alone, keep the root alone, keep it alone. Therefore, here you have to continue, children, here you will have to continue. You may not write this also. Therefore, 3 root 2 is equal to P upon Q. Ye jo hai, rational hai. That is P upon Q. E is rational. You have to keep on writing this. Make root 2 subject of the formula. Keep it alone. On which side is root 2? Left hand side. So on left hand side, what is additional with root 2? 3. What is the relation of 3 with root 2? Multiplication. So if you change the sign, it will divide. Therefore, root 2 is equal to P upon 3Q is rational. Now look here. P upon 3Q. This is integer, positive integer 3. That is rational. Right hand side is rational. But left hand side is irrational by 1. By the proved result. So this is Not correct, it contradicts. Okay, root 2 is equal to p upon 3q is rational. Right hand side is okay, p upon 3q is rational. But look at left hand side, root 2. Right hand side equal to left hand side. If right hand side is rational, left hand side is also rational. But that contradicts with 1. i.e. root 2 is rational. That left hand side, i.e. root 2 is rational. Which contradicts the result first. Which contradicts the result first. Now there is contradiction. So our supposition is wrong. Ye pura galat hai, so upar se hi galat aaya. Kya galat hai? Our supposition. What did we suppose? Suppose 3 root 2 is rational. Therefore, please pay attention. Therefore, our supposition that 3 root 2 is rational is untrue. Yeah, incorrect. So what is true? Therefore, 3 root 2 is irrational. Prove. Did you understand? We need a little bit of practice. Alright? Chal. Fifth one now. I hope you all are following it. Number 5. Show that 5 minus root 3 is irrational. Now again the monotonous one. Same type of work, similar type of work you have to do here. Chali. Which root is involved? Root 3. And 3 is prime. So root 3 is irrational. But we have to prove 5 minus root 3 is irrational. That is different expression. Correct? So first we will have to prove that root 3 is irrational. Let me remind you theorem 1.4 which stated, I think 1.3 which stated that root 2 is irrational. Root 2 is irrational. So only we know that root 2 is irrational by theorem. Okay? But root 3 is irrational we do not know. We proved that. Are you getting me? So here root 3 is irrational, that we have to prove. In the first case also, that is number 4, we proved that root 2 is irrational. It was not needed. Straight away you could have said root 2 is irrational by theorem 1.3. Is that clear to you? But then I said only for one case we have to do that. So for that also we will prove. So that in this type of sum, what we have to do is similar type of things. We will have enough practice. Okay? And we can do it automatically. Your brain and hand combination, it will go automatically. Right? If similar type of sum has to be done and if you have enough practice. Right? Chaliye. So first solution. First, we shall prove that root 3 is irrational. It is irrational, but we'll have to prove. How? Suppose root 3 is rational, i.e. root 3 is equal to m upon n, where n is not equal to 0, and HCF of m and n is equal to 1, call it result number 1. Then result number 2, then result number 3, then result number 4, if you remember, that contradicts. So our supposition is wrong. Thus, root 3 is irrational. We proved this and we are going to call it result first. This is result 1, 2, 3. This is result first. Okay? Now we move to the original expression which we have to show is irrational. Suppose, let me start from here so that we have enough space. Suppose 5 minus root 3 is rational. Now in the second part, you don't have to do this. So nothing writing. Okay, but this is rational, is rational, is rational. You will have to continue writing. I.e. 5 minus root 3 is equal to, I didn't use A upon B, so I can write here, A upon B. If this is rational, then you can write that is equal to A upon B. Is rational. Children, now you have to make root 3 subject of the formula. So what you do? Take minus, it's negative, see? So take it on the other side and bring A upon B here. 5 minus A upon B is equal to root 3. I just changed the side for root 3 and A upon B is rational, correct? Yeah, if you want, you there's no need to simplify. There's no need to simplify. This is rational. There's no doubt about that. Because A and B are integers, they are co-primes, 5. You simplify. Again, you will get A upon B formula, P upon Q formula, X upon Y formula, M upon N formula, which is rational. But right hand side root 3 is not rational. The statement says left hand side is rational, right hand side is rational, because left hand side equal to right hand side. But root 3 is irrational. But root 3 is irrational. You may say by result first. Therefore, there is contradiction. There is contradiction. There is contradiction. Contradiction, yeah, that means our supposition is wrong. Our supposition that 5 minus root 3 is rational is wrong. Thus, what is right then? 5 minus root 3 is irrational. Prove. It's not going to be easy, children. Let me tell you. You need complete understanding and plenty of practice. Alright? Let's see one more. Number 6. Are you getting me, children? Can you follow what I'm explaining? I hope so. Number 6. Show that 3 plus 2 root 5 is irrational. It is irrational. What is the main irrational part there? Root 5. So first you show that root 5 is irrational. Solution. First we show that root 5 is irrational. Suppose the converse. Root 5 is irrational, but we suppose root 5 is rational. I.e. root 5 is equal to P upon Q, where Q is not equal to 0, and HCF of P and Q is equal to 1, and that is result 1. Then go ahead, result 2. Go ahead, result 3. Go ahead, result 4. By 3 and 4. Yaad aaya aapko? By 3 and 4, there is contradiction. There is contradiction. Correct? So our supposition is wrong. Supposition is wrong. If supposition is wrong, what is supposition? Root 5 is rational. So what is correct? Thus, root 5 is irrational. And this we are going to call it result 1. Everything you have to write here, children, I'm not writing. Please, be careful. Okay. Now we move, after getting result first, we move on to our main proof, where we have to prove 3 plus 2 root 5 is irrational. We suppose the reverse. Suppose 3 plus 2 root 5 is rational. i.e. 3 plus 2 root 5 is equal to a upon b. And that is rational. Is rational. A rational suppose kiya, that can be written as a upon b. So, wo bhi rational. Now, we have to make root 5 subject of the formula. It is on left hand side. There are two terms. It is involved in the second term. So, first you get rid of the first term, which is plus 3. Take it on other side. So, 2 root pi remains as it is. That is equal to a upon b minus 3. A upon b minus 3. Is that clear to you? Now, we have to get rid of 2. So, it will go on other side and divide. Sure. So, therefore, root pi is equal to, children please, I am taking LCM here. What is LCM? B. B 1's are and 1 B's are. 1 into A is A minus 3 into B is 3B. Now I am getting rid of this 2 on the other side. So it goes down. Is rational. Keep on writing this statement. Is rational. Now observe. For any integer a and b, select any integer, put the values and find the value of the whole expression. It's called rational expression because it is of the form m upon n. The value of this expression would be always rational number. Take any integer, integral value of a and b, put them and find out the value of right hand side. It will be always rational number. But this is not. Okay. Are you getting me? But root 5 is irrational. See, you may write like this also. What this shows, left hand side is equal to right hand side is rational. To come to left hand side is also rational. I.e. root 5 is rational. Which contradicts with the result in one, in first, athwa with the result first. Therefore, our supposition that 3 plus 2 root 5 is rational. Is incorrect. I use this word. Then what is correct? Therefore, 3 plus 2 root 5 is rational. Sorry, irrational. Proof. Clear? Have you followed, children? Not easy. Alright? Let's see one more of this kind. Seventh one. Show that root 5 upon, okay, let me take root 7 upon 3 minus 5 is irrational. It's an expression having two terms and root 7 is actually irrational. So first we'll have to show that root 7 is irrational. Solution. First, we show that root 7 is irrational. And for that, we have to do the method which we saw in the last session, in the last video, video 8, right? Suppose root 7 is rational. If it is rational, then root 7 is equal to a upon b form, where b is not equal to 0, and HCF of a and b equal to 1, result 1. All this you write and ultimately you get, thus root 7 is irrational. Okay, result first. Alright, Now we move on to our main expression, which we have to show is irrational. Now suppose root 7 upon 3 minus 5 is rational. That means it is of the form m upon n. This time I'll put m upon n. Root 7 upon 3 minus 5 is equal to m upon n is rational. You have to continue this. Now, children, you have to make root 7 subject of the formula. Means what? Where is root 7? On left hand side. So 5 and 3 are to be got rid of from left hand side. They have to be taken on right hand side and keep root 7 alone. That is making root 7 subject of the formula. This procedure. What will be the first step in the procedure? Taking minus 5 on the other side. Therefore, root 7 upon 3 is equal to m upon n minus 5 on the other side plus 5. Therefore, root 7 upon 3 is equal to, take LCM. LCM is n. Right? N 1s are and 1 n's are. So what you have? 1 into m is m plus 5 into n is 5n. Is rational, that you have to keep on writing. Is rational. Alright? Got it? No doubt. Still you have to get rid of 3. 3 is dividing root 7. On the other side it will multiply. Therefore, root 7 is equal to 3 cross multiply. 3 goes up. 3 times m plus 5n upon n is rational. Children, your right hand side is rational. आप कोई भी वैल्यू, कोई भी इंटीग्रल वैल्यू m और n की चूज करो, अंदर डालो और ये राइट हैंड साइड का वैल्यू ढूंढो, इट विल बी ऑलवेज अ रेशनल नंबर. सो वो तो रेशनल नंबर है, राइट हैंड साइड इज रेशनल नंबर, बट व्हाट अबाउट लेफ्ट हैंड साइड? ये स्टेटमेंट तो कह रहा है कि लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज ऑल्सो रेशनल, बट दैट कॉन्ट्रडिक्ट्स विद द रिजल्ट 1. i.e. root 7 इज रेशनल. इससे पता चलता है ऊपर वाले स्टेटमेंट से कि root 7 इज रेशनल. लेकिन इट कॉन्ट्राडिक्ट्स विद फर्स्ट, विच कॉन्ट्राडिक्ट्स विद रिजल्ट 1 फर्स्ट. वो कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन हो गया. क्यों? क्योंकि हमारा सपोजिशन रॉन्ग है. देयरफॉर आवर सपोजिशन दैट रूट 7 अपॉन 3 माइनस 5 इज रेशनल इज रॉन्ग. If that is wrong, what is correct? Therefore, root 7 upon 3 minus 5 is irrational. And that's proved. I hope it's clear, children. Okay, students. So now we move on to the last concept of this chapter, and the chapter gets over. Alright? This you have already studied in standard 9. So we are just revisiting this concept. Okay, don't look at these two statements right now. See what I am writing on the board. Observe well and understand well. Let me take few rational numbers. When you express them in decimal fraction, it is terminating. Like 3 upon 4, 2 upon 5, 5 upon 8. 17 upon 50. Alright. I know all these rational numbers. If you express them in decimal form, it will have terminating decimal. Let's see. 3 divided by 4. 0. 4 sevens are 28. 2 remains 0. 4 fives are 20. So division stopped. And after 2 places of decimal. So this is 0.75. 2 divided by 5, 0. 5 fours are 20. See, this is 0.75. This value is 0.4. Alright. Let's see this. 5 divided by 8, 0. 8 6s are 48. 2 remains 0. 8 2s are 16. 4 remains 0. 8 pi's are 40 and 0. So division stopped. So pi upon 8 is 0.62 pi. 0.625. Last but not the least, 17 divided by 50. 0.0. 50 threes are 150, 20 remains 0. 50 fours are 200 and 0. So that last is 0.34. In all four cases, the remainders obtained during the division is 0. That means the division stops. So after how many decimal places division stops here? After 2. Here after 1. Here after 3. Here after 2. Children, observe one thing. First check whether this is in its reduced form. 3 or 4 ka GCD, LCF of 3 and 4, that is 1. 2 and pi, HCF of 2 and pi, that is 1. HCF of 5 and 8, that is 1. HCF of 17 and 50, that is also 1. So you have to see, make sure that HCF of numerator and denominator is 1. In other words, numerator and denominator have to be coterminous, correct? After that, you factorize this denominator. Only the denominators are to be factorized. Obtain their prime factors. 2 2s are, 2 1s are. 5. 5 1s are. 8. 2 4s are, 2 2s are, 2 1s are. 50. 2 25s are, 5 5s are, 5 1s are. Children, now see how this 4 I am going to represent. 4 is equal to 2 square. Let me write 5. 5 is equal to pi raised to 1. 8, that is 2 cubed. And 50, that is 2 raised to 1 into pi square. 2 raised to 1 into pi square. This is 2 cubed. This is 5 raised to 1 and this is 2 square. Children, pay attention. Very interesting. Here, powers with base 2 and 5 are existing. Here, it's only power with base 2. Only power with base 5. And here, power with base 2. I can write here 1. Can I write 1? 1 is 5 raised to 0. Anything raised to 0 is 1. Anything raised to 0 is 1. Right? So here I write 5 raised to 0. Here also into 1. But I need 2. 2 or 5 base wale powers chahiye. So I will write 2 raised to 0. Here base 2 is there, 5 is missing. So pi raised to 0. Here both bases are there. Base 2 and base 5 for both the powers. So when you are able to express this denominators of rational number in the form of product of two powers with base 2 and pi, it is confirmed that is terminating decimal expansion. Those rational numbers have terminating decimal expansion. Two things to be tested. Number one, numerator, denominator are co-primes. Then denominators, the prime factorization of denominators can be expressed as product of two powers only. Only two powers. One with base 2 and other with base 5. So you can see 4 can be represented as product of 2 powers with base 2 and pi. 5 and 2. 2 and pi. 5 and 2. 2 and pi. This exponent you check out. Koi bhi exponent negative nahi hai. There is no exponent which is negative, and that is the definition of power as well. So the index that you have should be non-negative integer. Non-negative means what? Either positive or zero. Zero bhi chalta hai. Zero will do because it is non-negative. Zero is non-negative. Alright. Did you understand? Okay. Children, how many places of decimal here? Two. That you come to know from this. Children, ye 4 ka prime factorization hai. पाव विद बेस 2 और पाव विद बेस 5, उसके अलावा कुछ भी नहीं है. सी द इंडेक्स 2 एंड इंडेक्स 0 विच इज द हाइएस्ट 2, सो इट टर्मिनेट्स आफ्टर 2 प्लेसेस ऑफ डेसिमल. लेट्स चेक द नेक्स्ट 5, इट इज 5 रेस टू 1 एंड 2 रेस टू 0 विच इज द हायर इंडेक्स 1, सो इट टर्मिनेट्स आफ्टर 1 डेसिमल. कैन यू सी दैट पॉइंट के बाद, एक डिजिट के बाद द डिविजन स्टॉप्स. Next, this 8, 2 cube into 5 raised to 0, which is the higher exponent 3, so it terminates after 3 decimal places. And the last one, 50, 2 raised to 1, pi square, 2 is the higher index, so it terminates after 2 decimal. So when you are able to express any number, that is the denominator of rational number, in its reduced form, in the form 2 raised to n into pi raised to m. If that denominator, say suppose a upon b, then this b is represented in this form, then you can say that is terminating decimal expansion. That rational number can be expressed as terminating decimal expansion. I hope you understood. Now see, same statement is in the form of theorem 1.5. Let x be any rational number. This rational numbers which I chose, let's say that is x. Let x be any rational number whose decimal expansion terminates. Aapne dekha, sabka decimal expansion terminating hai. Then x can be, that x, 4, 5, 8 and 50, can be expressed in the form P upon Q, where P and Q are co-primes, correct? And the prime factorization of Q, jo denominator mein hai, the prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 raised to M into pi raised to M. Usko aap is tarah represent kar payenge if it is terminating decimal expansion. Or after how many places of decimal it will terminate? N और M में जो बड़ा हो, that many places of decimal के बाद वो terminate होगा. Is that clear to you? So I hope you understood the statement. Now this statement is exactly the converse of it. Alright? इसने क्या बोला? If any rational number terminating decimal expansion है, तो उसका denominator Q can be expressed in this form. Now उसका उल्टा, if rational expression is given with denominator which can be expressed in this form, then that rational number can be expressed as terminating decimal expansion. It may be confusing, but you see these two statements nicely. Yeah? Please try to understand. I'll read the statement of theorem 1.6. Both the statements are there in your textbooks. Try to understand them well. I've explained to you. See this. Let x be p upon q. That means any rational number. Such that prime factorization of Q is of the form 2 raised to n into pi raised to m, where n and m are non-negative integers. It can be 0 and positive but not negative. Then x has decimal expansion which terminates. Is that clear? Our last concept is based on theorem 1.6. They are going to give us number of rational numbers, and we have to decide whether it is terminating or non-terminating, and if it is terminating, after how many decimal places it will terminate without actual division. आपको पता है मैंने actual division से भी उसका decimal expansion form में express किया. Are you getting me? But without actual division, आपको बताना है whether it is terminating or non-terminating. You can use theorem 1.6. Let's see. First number, 13 upon 3125. Baap re, पहले तो check करना होगा whether it is in its reduced form or not. जो बड़ा number है, denominator first you find out, the prime factors of denominator. 3125, 5 से divisible है. 5 6 za 1, 5 2 za 2, 5 5 za 5 1 za 2 za 5 5 za 5 2 za 5 za 5 5 za 5 1. So all 5s you can see here. The prime factorization of 3125 is all 5. और 13 खुद प्राइम है, 13 वन्स मतलब कुछ भी कैंसिल होने वाला नहीं है, बिकॉज नो कॉमन प्राइम फैक्टर्स आर देयर फॉर 13 एंड 3125, सो इट इज ऑलरेडी इन इट्स रिड्यूस्ड फॉर्म. पहला टेस्ट हो गया. नाउ यू चेक ओनली द डिनोमिनेटर, ए 3125 इज इक्वल टू, सी इट्स प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन, 5 इज मल्टीप्लाइड विद इटसेल्फ 5 टाइम्स. अरे हमें तो एक्सप्रेस करना है इनटू कौन सा बेस, 2 भी चाहिए, 2 raised to 0 है ही नहीं 2, so I'll write 2 raised to 0. 2 raised to 0 is actually 1. You know that. So see, the denominator can be expressed in this form. Product of powers with base 5 and 2. Nothing else. There are no more powers. Okay. So yes, this is terminating decimal fraction. This rational number has expansion, which is decimal expansion, which is terminating. Can you tell me after how many decimal places it will terminate? ये n है या m या ये m या n whatever, कौन सा बड़ा है? 5 बड़ा है, so it is going to terminate after 5 decimal places. Got it children? Number two, and it is 17/8. पहले denominator जो बड़ा number है उसका prime factorization. ये तो prime number ही है, 17 ones है. 8, 2 4s are 2, 2s are 2, 1s are, कुछ भी कॉमन नहीं है. सो दिस रेशनल नंबर इज इन इट्स रिड्यूस्ड फॉर्म. 17 एंड 8 आर को प्राइम्स, वो टेस्ट हो गई. नाउ जस्ट डिनोमिनेटर, ये 8, दैट इज इक्वल टू, इट्स ऑलरेडी फैक्टराइज्ड, 2 इनटू 2 इनटू 2, 2 क्यूब, 5 नहीं है, बट वी कैन ऐड, आई मीन वी कैन मल्टीप्लाई, 5 रेज्ड टू 0. सो दिस डिनोमिनेटर कैन बी एक्सप्रेस्ड इन दिस फॉर्म, ये फॉर्म में आप एक्सप्रेस कर पा रहे हैं. सो दैट मींस दिस इज ऑल्सो अ टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल फॉर्म. दिस रेशनल नंबर कैन बी एक्सप्रेस इन टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल फॉर्म. एंड आफ्टर हाउ मेनी प्लेसेस इट विल टर्मिनेट, देख लो एक्सपोनेंट में 3 बड़ा है, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू टर्मिनेट आफ्टर 3 प्लेसेस ऑफ डेसिमल. चलो चेक करते हैं, 17 डिवाइड बाय 8, 8 टू 16, 1 रिमेन. नाउ कम्स द डेसिमल, 0 here, 8 ones are 8, 2 is the remainder. Since you have put decimal, you can continue 0. 8 twos are 16, 4 is the remainder, you can continue 0. 8 fives are 40, terminate ho gaya. And you see after 3 places of decimal, 1 to 3. So 3 places of decimal ke baad wo terminate ho gaya. But actual division se nahi karna hai, ye sirf check karne ke liye humne kiya. Now number 3. Ready? Number 3. It is 64/455. पहले डिनोमिनेटर का प्राइम फैक्टर्स निकाल देते हैं, वो तो चाहिए ही चाहिए. 5 से डिविजिबल है, 5 9s are 5 1s are. ए चिल्ड्रन 91 कहीं पे याद आ रहा है, 7 से 7 1s are 7, 2 7 3s are and 13 1s are. So these are the prime factors of 455. 64 के प्राइम फैक्टर्स, अरे इसमें तो सब 2 है, 2s only, 2s only. So, कुछ भी कॉमन नहीं है, दैट मीन्स 64 एंड 455 आर को प्राइम्स. पहला टेस्ट हो गया. नाउ डिनोमिनेटर ऑलरेडी फैक्टर्स निकाले हैं, ये इसके फैक्टर्स बोलो, 5 रेज टू 1 इंटू 7 इंटू 13, 2 नहीं मिल रहा है, सो आई कैन राइट 2, 2 रेज टू 0. भाई 5 और 2 तो है, लेकिन ये कुछ एडिशनल है, इसको हम कहेंगे कबाब में हड्डी. कबाब में हड्डी, ये कबाब में हड्डी नहीं चाहिए, यदि कबाब में हड्डी आई तो ये टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल नहीं है. सो मिल गया, सिर्फ 5 रेस टू 1 इंटू 2 रेस टू 0 होता तो दिस रेशनल एक्सप्रेशन या रेशनल नंबर वुड हैव बीन टर्मिनेटिंग वन, बट इट इज नॉट टर्मिनेटिंग बिकॉज ऑफ कबाब में हड्डी. समझ में आया, जब भी कबाब में हड्डी आएगी तो इट इज नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल. All right, but it will be recurring, that you learn in 9th standard. Okay. Next, fourth one, 15/1600. Sirf denominator dekh lete hain. 1600. 2 800s are, 2 400s are, 2 200s are, 2 100s are. 2 0 pata hai, double 2 or double 5 hota hai.
100 में डबल टू और डबल पाई, 10 में सिंगल टू सिंगल पाई, 1000 में ट्रिपल टू ट्रिपल पाई, 10,000 में 4 टू 4 पाई। तो डायरेक्ट मैंने लिख दिया, ये सब राइट साइड नहीं लिखा। अभी ये 15, 3 पाई जा पाई वन जा, ए चिल्ड्रन कुछ कॉमन है, सो दिस कैन बी रिड्यूस, रिड्यूस करो, दैट इज इक्वल टू 5, 3 जा 5, 3 जा 15, 1 बचा, 5 टू जा और 0 जा, so this is 3 upon 320, 3 upon 320, और इसको कैंसल भी कर दो, और ये 1600 नहीं रहा, ये 320 रहा और ये 3 रहा, आपको रिड्यूस फॉर्म मिल गया। अब डिनोमिनेटर का प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन देखना है, 2 इज मल्टीप्लाइड विद इटसेल्फ 6 टाइम्स इनटू 5 रेस टू 1, 5 इज दिस 5 रेस टू 1, कबाब में हड्डी नहीं है, 2 रेस टू 6 इनटू 5 रेस टू 1, सो दिस वन इज अ टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन, दिस रेशनल नंबर इज टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन, इज दैट क्लियर टू यू? एंड आफ्टर हाउ मेनी प्लेसेस ऑफ डेसिमल इट विल टर्मिनेट, 6 और 1 में बड़ा कौन सा, 6, सो इट्स गोइंग टू टर्मिनेट आफ्टर 6 प्लेसेस ऑफ डेसिमल, ऑलराइट, एक्चुअली 3 अपॉन 320 इज इक्वल टू, आई यूज कैलकुलेटर नाउ, आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिवाइड एट दिस टाइम, इट इज 3 डिवाइड बाई 320, 3 divided by 320, that is 0.009375, 0.009375, 2, 4 and a 6, are you getting me? See, 6 places of decimal, which we came to know from here, we don't have to divide and see, clear children, fine, next. Now it's number 5. 29 upon 343. पहले इसका कुछ याद आ रहा है? 343. It's cube of 7. 7 4s are 28. 7 9s are 7. 7s are 7 1s are. और 29 तो prime ही है. चल रहा है 1 to 100 prime numbers learn करना. 29 1s are 29. So there's nothing common. So already in its reduced form. 29 और 3, 43 आर को प्राइम्स, अभी सिर्फ डिनोमिनेटर का प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन, वो तो हो गया 7 क्यूब, 7 क्यूब, अब यहां तो 5 भी नहीं है, 2 भी नहीं, आपको लिखना है तो लिख सकते हैं 5 रेस टू 0 इंटू 2 रेस टू 0, लेकिन ये कबाब इसके अलावा ये भी है, सो कबाब में हड्डी है, सो दिस इज नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन, इज दैट क्लियर? और नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग है तो नंबर ऑफ डेसिमल प्लेसेस आएगा ही नहीं। Number 6, 23 upon 2 square into pi cube. इसको कुछ भी करना नहीं है, आपको तो डायरेक्ट दे दिया है, the food is already served in your dish, 2 square into pi cube, prime factorization of denominator is already given, alright, उसमें कोई कबाब में हड्डी भी नहीं है, so सीधे बोल दो, this is terminating decimal expansion. This rational number has terminating decimal expansion. Okay. Next. Number 7. 129 upon 2 square into 5 raised to 7 into 7 raised to 5. Once again, aapki thali mein pirsa gaya hai khana. Khalo. Seedha. Already, prime factorization is given. 2 raise to 2 square है, 5 raise to 7 है, लेकिन कुछ odd चीज भी है, कबाब में हड्डी भी है, so this is non-terminating decimal expansion, clear? Number 8, 6 upon 15, now this is very interesting, चलो, suppose आप reduce नहीं कर रहे, तो 15 is 3 into 5, है ना? 15 का प्राइम फैक्टर्स आप निकालेंगे 3 5 जा 5 1 जा 3 1 और वो 2 रेस टू 0 तो आप लिख सकते हैं, तो आप बोलेंगे यहां कबाब में हड्डी है, सो इट इज नॉट टर्मिनेटिंग, लेकिन आपने रिड्यूस तो नहीं किया, रिड्यूस करना चाहिए ना, क्योंकि पहला प्रोसीजर तो वो है, देख लीजिए रिड्यूस करने से क्या होता है, चलिए डिनोमिनेटर का प्राइम फैक्टर्स निकाल दिया, 6 का निकालो 2 3 जा और 3 1 जा,
वेल कॉमन
है क्या नहीं? सो थ्री टू जा थ्री पाई जा, सो नाउ यू गॉट टू एंड पाई, ये थ्री यहां से निकाल दो, ये पाई दोनों जगह से थ्री निकाल दो, कैंसिल कर दिया। ऑलराइट, सो अब डिनोमिनेटर में क्या रहा? फाइव, दैट इज फाइव रेस टू वन। यू मे राइट टू रेस टू जीरो मल्टीप्लाई बाई टू रेस टू जीरो, सो आपको दिखता है फाइव रेस टू वन एंड टू रेस टू जीरो, उसके अलावा कोई भी और नंबर नहीं है। सो दिस इज टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल, आप रिड्यूस करने बगैर देखते तो नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग आता, समझ में आया बात? ओके, एंड इट विल टर्मिनेट आफ्टर वन प्लेस ऑफ डेसिमल। चलिए नंबर नाइन, 30 pi upon 50. अब मैं एक हिंट देता हूं, चल रहा सिर्फ डिनोमिनेटर को प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन देता हूं, 225 5 5 5 1। प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन में इफ यू गेट प्राइम फैक्टर अदर देन 2 एंड पाई तभी आप रिड्यूस करो, लेकिन रिड्यूस करना भूलना नहीं, यहां आप रिड्यूस करने से बच सकते हैं क्योंकि डिनोमिनेटर के प्राइम फैक्टर्स में 2 और 5 के अलावा कोई और प्राइम फैक्टर नहीं है, सो रिड्यूस करने की जरूरत नहीं है। आर यू गेटिंग मी? या जरूरत है कर लो, वो रिड्यूस होता है 5 7 7 1, 5 इज कॉमन, ये कैंसिल ही कर दो, सो यहां बचा ये ऊपर बचा 7 और 50 में से बचा 10, समझ में आई बात? और इसका प्राइम फैक्टर्स देख लो, जो बचा है 2 raised to 1 into 5 raised to, उसमें कबाब में हड्डी नहीं है, so this is terminating decimal expansion and it's going to terminate after one place, यहाँ कोई भी देखो सेम ही है, so after one place of decimal, यहाँ से देखते तो आप बोलते 2 place of decimal, right? Okay. The last for this chapter and that is 77 upon 210. पहले डिनोमिनेटर का प्राइम फैक्टर्स 2 1 0 5 5 2 1 3 7 7 1 77 7 11 11 1 7 7 कट कर दो, मतलब रिड्यूस हो रहा है, 7 कट करने के बाद हमें क्या मिला? 5 2 10, सॉरी वो डिनोमिनेटर में आएगा, ये डिनोमिनेटर है 30, राइट, एंड दैट वन इज 11। इसके प्राइम फैक्टर्स देख लो, ये 30 हो गया और ये 11 हो गया, राइट, ऊपर 11 हो गया, उसके प्राइम फैक्टर्स 2 into 3 into 5, वेल ये तो है लेकिन साथ में कबाब में हड्डी भी है, सो दिस इज नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल। सो चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव फिनिश्ड द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, बी प्रिपेयर्ड, आई विल डिक्लेयर द डेट ऑफ योर टेस्ट, सो यू विल बी आंसरिंग क्वाइट लेंथी टेस्ट ऑफ 2 hours, ऑलराइट, 50 मार्क्स टेस्ट, should it be short, we'll see, I'll declare the date, the marks also, I'll give you the style of paper also, and then you will answer the test, is that clear to you? Okay, you will see one more video where we'll solve some optional questions, they won't be asked in the board examination, but when we are doing this chapter real numbers, you should know about it, okay, so aapko pata hai na लास्ट एक्सरसाइज ऑप्शनल एक्सरसाइज है, लेकिन उसमें आपको बोर्ड में क्वेश्चन नहीं आते उसमें से, तो उस प्रकार के कुछ ऑप्शनल क्वेश्चन हम सॉल्व करेंगे और पूरा चैप्टर का रिवीजन मतलब ओनली व्हाट वी सॉ, हमने क्या लर्न किया उसको सब रिकॉल करेंगे। इज दैट क्लियर? सो बेस्ट ऑफ लक, वर्क हार्ड, थैंक यू।